Hello. Hey there.
Oh,
oh
God.
Idea that only the classics are a proper realm of study for young ladies. The classics do have their place, and I will send you to classical works on occasion, as I did with your study of morality. But I intend such tangents to be adjuncts to your current projects. Those must be the focus, not long-lost historical conundrums. Shallan nodded. But Yasna, aren't you a historian? Aren't those long-lost historical conundrums the meat of your field? I'm a Veristatalian, Yasna said. We search for answers in the past, reconstructing what truly happened. To many, writing a history is not about truth, but about presenting the most flattering picture of themselves and their motives. My sisters and I choose projects that we feel were misunderstood or misrepresented, and in studying them, hope to better understand the present. Are you spending so much time studying folk tales and looking for evil spirits? No. Yasna was searching for something real. Something so important that it drew her away from the shattered plains and the fight to avenge her father. She intended to do something with those folk tales, and Shallan's research was part of it somehow. That excited her. It was the sort of thing she wanted. Tomorrow morning.
she won't be surprised. I need to cry, break down, give up. I need to... What is Urethiru? Shallan found herself asking instead. To her surprise, Yasna answered without hesitation. Urethiru was said to be the center of the Silver Kingdom, a city that held 10 thrones, one for each king. It was the most majestic, most amazing, most important city in all the world. Really? Why haven't I heard of it before? Because it was abandoned.
Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how about yourself?
Good.
But the pretense of searching for it would give her time away from Yasna. And during that time, she'd see what she could discover about the Voidbringers on her own. 2 hours later, Shallan sat at a cluttered desk at the back of one of the Palinaeum's lower-level rooms, her sphere lantern illuminating a stack of hastily gathered volumes, none of which had proven much use. It seemed that everybody knew something about the Voidbringers. People in rural areas
work of a void bringer. Scholars laughed at all these ideas. Actual historical accounts, the ones she could find quickly, were contradictory. Were the void bringers the denizens of damnation? If so, wouldn't damnation